Welcome to WSF Radio. I'm Alejandro, and I'm going to be showing you guys, all of you who are hearing this, the reviews of this channel. Wish you like it, and here comes the rest of the gang.
Hi, I'm Andrew, and I'm going to be doing the interviews, so I hope you like it.
Hi, my name is Ishwar, and I'm going to be doing the world news.
Hi, my name is Faris. I'll do reviews too.
Hi, it's me, Hamza, and today I'm going to do school news for WSF Radio.
There we go.
Woo-hoo. Come and move that in my direction. So thankful for that, it's such a blessing, yeah. Turn every situation into heaven, yeah. You are my sunrise on the darkest day. Got me feeling some kind of way. Make me wanna savor every moment. Slowly. You fit me, telling me love how you put it on. Got the only key, know how to turn it on. The way you nibble on my ear, the only words I wanna hear. Baby, take it slow so we can last long.
Tú eres el imán y yo soy el metal. Me voy acercando y voy armando el plan. Solo con pensarlo se acelera el pulso.
Oh yeah. Ya me está gustando más de lo normal. Todo mi sentido va pidiendo más. Esto hay que tomarlo sin ningún apuro.
Despacito, quiero respirar tu cuello despacito. Deja que te diga cosas al oído, para que te acuerdes si no estás conmigo. Despacito, quiero desnudarte a besos despacito. Firmo las paredes de tu laberinto y hacer de tu cuerpo todo un manuscrito.
That song was Despacito by Justin Bieber. It's not the Spanish one, but it's the English one.
Hi, my name is Hamza, and I'll be doing world news. First topic is about a NASA astronaut. NASA astronaut Randy Bresnik took a fidget spinner into space without any piece of gravity. He's shown us a lot of cool tricks with it, like, for example, spinning it around in the air, or maybe throwing it around as it spins, flying around it. Second, Lionel Messi celebrates with his teammates in Argentina after their victory over Ecuador, a football team. Messi can be their only chance for Argentina to be world champion before they retire. There has been made a hotel for just dogs, and they can stay there if their, for example, owner is on vacation, or just for daycare if their owner doesn't know exactly how to take care of them. Thank you for listening, and I'll hand it over to the next part of the radio.
Now we're gonna go to the reviews with Alejandro and Faris.
Are you ready to play?
It's review time!
Welcome back! Welcome, guys! You already heard me at the beginning. Today I'm gonna be reviewing one of the best books in all UK. Would you like it? It's Harry Potter and the Chamber of Secrets. I'm gonna be showing you how it is and why do I like it a lot. As well, this book is about, like, you may know already the Harry Potter movies. They're really famous. This is a rated version of those movies. I mean, I like it because the way they wrote it, it's a way that everyone can imagine how it is. It's made by J.K. Rowling or Joanne Rowling, which is a really good writer, if you ask me. If you want if you want to buy them, you can just go to Bloomsbury.com. As well, she used Latin words for the spells and the enchantments in Harry Potter series, which is a lot of coincidence because I speak Spanish. You may already know who I am. I'm the only kid here that speaks Spanish. So we're going right now to Ferris.
And hi there, gamers. My name is Ferris, and now I'm gonna do the reviews. Today's game is Sonic Mania. Okay. In a new interview, it seems that the recently released and throughoutly excellent Sonic Mania could be connected to the upcoming Sonic Forces that is released this November, courtesy of Takamoto. We have a new interview with the head of Sonic Team, Takashi, and in it, he explains that the two games could be connected in some way. Last month, in August, was released a game called Sonic Mania that got a really warm welcome from everyone in the community, from all the fans, especially our board. A lot of people enjoyed playing it, and I really hope if you played Sonic Mania, you get to play Sonic Forces too, because you may think those titles are unrelated, but actually they might not be. Definitely, I want you guys to check out both titles because there's something going on between the two. I'm going to keep this on right now. It's not clear what this connection could be, but my guess that it could be a narrative one. Maybe even trunk into the Phantom Ruby was the key plot in Sonic Mania. That said, we already know that the drop dash from Sonic Mania is coming to Sonic Forces, so this connection could be due with this. Whatever this connection might be between the two games, ultimately Sonic Forces will have a tougher time of appealing to fans of classic Sonic the Hedgehog. One of the main draws of Sonic Mania is that it was all new yet classically crafted Sonic the Hedgehog game. By construct, Sonic Forces is functionally tied to the later games that many was divided from what fans actually wanted from the series. So whatever Sonic Team has planned for Sonic Forces, it definitely has a word cut out for it since the success of Sonic Mania. Sonic Forces is released for PS4, Xbox One, Switch, and PC on November 7th.
Thank you, guys.
Thank you, Alejandro Ferris. Amazing review.
Alright guys, that was Ninjago song. It's not the one from the movie, but it's from the classic series. If you've got the game, you may already have seen the characters. If you've got all 101, but there are 102 actually. There's one hidden that you need a special disc. No one has it, and I don't know how to get it.
Good morning, gents. I'm Andrew.
and today I'm going to be interviewing Randu, who is the Vice President of GEMS Education. Good morning.
Good morning, Andrew. I'm very, very excited to be sitting in front of you and talking to you.
Thank you. Is it okay if we ask you some questions?
Indeed. And then remember, I have to ask you a few questions as well.
Okay. What inspired you to join GEMS Education?
Well, more than what inspired me to GEMS Education, I think I was inspired by our chairman once I joined and I got to know his vision to continue and stay with GEMS. I've been working with GEMS for 21 years. So perhaps I would say I joined by accident, but I continued because I was so inspired by the vision of our chairman, by the growth GEMS was having. It was expanding exponentially. There were so many opportunities. There were so many people I got to know and learn from. And that was a personal and professional growth and development for me.
Okay. We know that you're a very important person, but what does the Vice President of GEMS do?
So what we do is we are supporting schools. So I'm actually part of, at the moment, 9 schools, and we are opening 3 more schools in my cluster, the similar kind of schools around different Emirates in the UAE. So I'm there to support them so that the schools and the principals and the staff of the schools achieve what they aspire and what they want to achieve for that school, to give the best education experience, the best learning experience to all our children.
Do you have any brothers and sisters, and what do they do?
So I have one older sister who was a teacher as well, but she's not working at the moment.
When you have free time, what do you do?
When I have free time, I love to just relax, but I'm also a very creative person and I do some art and craft.
What is your favorite childhood memory?
My favorite childhood memory is playing with friends, visiting relatives. And I say that favorite childhood memory because it doesn't happen as much these days. We are so much in our very isolated families that perhaps I feel guilty because I don't think I have taken my children to spend a summer or a holiday with some of our relatives or stay there with them and, you know, interact with their children and find out and, you know, kind of cook with them or spend time with them. It doesn't happen. We're all very busy and we just go visit them, come back, visit them, come back. So it's not really getting to know family, really. That's why.
What's your favorite movie and why?
What's my favorite movie recently? To be honest, Andrew, I watch movies and I forget. But in general, I love movies which have fun, which have sense of humor, because we are just so busy and so stressed that I don't want to see movies which have a lot of action and a lot of fight and violence. I really want to watch movies which are just relaxing, fun, laugh, and come back. And I honestly just forget about that.
Where were you born?
I was born in India.
If you had like one day to have any superpower, what would it be?
The superpower. You know, I admire the leaders of UAE so much because each one of them is contributing in some or the other way. So I would like to become one of them to see how does it feel to be in that place where you are the leader of an emirate or of a country, and how you can influence that.
What's your favorite food and why?
Mexican. I love Mexican because there's a burst of flavors in Mexican food and I can have as much as possible.
What's your favorite book?
Visible Learning by John Hattie, which is for children, and there is so much to read, adapt, learn, apply, and I just love that book.
Thank you so much.
You're welcome. And is it my turn now, Andrew?
Yeah.
What do you enjoy the most in this school?
I enjoy the club.
Mm-hmm.
And I also enjoy history and geography.
Lovely. You are such a delightful child.
Thank you so much.
And if you had to change one thing about the school, what would that be?
It would be that everyone in the school would just like be good with each other and no one would fight.
Mm-hmm.
And that everyone would like everybody and that everyone in the school would be just friends.
And you know, you have the superpower to influence that. You can actually send this message across to everyone, isn't it?
I think so, but yes. I'm not sure.
Lovely. You should be very sure of that, Andrew.
Thank you.
It was a pleasure being with you.
The pleasure is mine.
Thank you.
Thank you.
5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
Better sounds no one's ever heard. I wish I had a better voice to sing some better words. I wish I found some chords in an order that is new. I wish I didn't have to rhyme every time I sang. I was told when I get older all my fears would shrink, but now I'm insecure and I care what people think.
My name's blurry face and I care what you think. My name's blurry face and I care what you think. Wish we could turn back time.
That song was stressed out by 21 Pilots, and I hope you enjoyed it.
My name is Hamza, and me and my friend Ishfar will be your host for school news. Our first topic is radio opening. Our radio has been open for 2 weeks, and this is the third. The past 2 weeks, we have been setting up certain things, like maybe jingles or setting up our sayings for today. Now let's talk more specifically. Week one, we didn't have much time, so we just set up a paper of everything that we will do throughout the year. Week two, we made all our jingles for the following. School news, news, interviews, shout-outs, reviews, reading work, and music, or maybe songs. And now, in week three, we are here to talk with you about all of this. Our second topic is assessments. This week, has been full of assessments. Am I correct, Ishfar?
Yes, you are.
Yes. So in this week, it has been full, and by full, I mean full of assessments. And you think this is it for this week? Think again. We're just getting started. This was just the first week for grades 1 and 4 to 9. But next week, grade 2 and 3 are going to do 3 English assessments. Reading comprehension, grammar, math, science, and makeup tests. So basically all the English language tests for grade 2 and 3 are next week. Our third topic is the school trip. Now, if you're a 4th to 9th grader, don't get too excited because the trip is only for grade 2. But don't worry, here on WSF we will be telling you everything we know about it. First, we'll tell you when it will be. It has actually been done recently, and by recently I mean today. They got out of school at 8:30 a.m. and came back at 12 o'clock. and continued their normal school day. Now, this trip wasn't normal. They had their science lesson in it. They learned about plants, made a tree survey, and might have had a puppet show. And one more interesting thing is there were 110 students, and all went to one park, Kalba Cornish Park. Our fourth and last topic is the WSF team. Ishfar, haven't you heard about it?
Yes, I have.
The football team.
Yes.
So this week, our nearly all school PE teacher, Mr. Agnell, has chosen our WSF football team. He has chosen a few people from grade 4 and a few from grade 5 and the other grades too. They are all very proud to be in this team, so don't think you can convince them to give you their place, because I tried and it does not work. If you want to know more, go to Mr. Agnell and ask him for more, like, for example, the names of the players. Thanks for listening to the school news, and I'll hand it over to the next topic.
Is made by the game Sonic Mania. I hope you enjoyed it. If you played Sonic Mania, you already know the song. Thank you.
Welcome, guys. Today we have the riddle of the day. Come on, Alejandro, you can lead us off.
All right. A cowboy went to town on Friday.
He stayed for 3 days and left town on Friday. How did he do it? Tell us. Put the box inside the shout-outs box just outside our classroom. And next week, we're going to tell you who the winner is.
Now, it's time for shout-outs.
Hi there, guys. It's shout-outs time.
All right, guys. First shout-out we've got is Summer, one of our teachers. It says that I suggest if the students can broadcast news early morning in the daily assembly, EX telling school news. Interesting facts. Well, Summer, if you're hearing this, that would work. I think we can do it.
Yeah. Sure.
Maybe. Guys, what do you think?
Yeah.
Ishwar.
What?
What's your opinion?
If the student on the assembly or maybe.
Okay.
Well, Summer, well, if they say yes, I say yes also.
Me too.
This shout out says Mr. Short Smiley Face. Whoever wrote that.
Please be more specific.
Wow.
Yes, please. Thank you.
This shout out is to Hadi in grade 6B2. Good boy, strong head on his young shoulders, golden heart, smiley face from Mr. Jacko and Mr. Short.
This shout out is for me, for helping Mr. Short with the WSF radio display and lots of painting too.
Well, thank you guys.
Thank you guys for listening to the radio. We'll see you in the next episode.
Bye.
Goodbye. See you later.
Okay, guys, thank you very much for listening. This is Mr. Short. The boys who you hear today on the radio did everything themselves, so I'm very, very, very proud of them. I hope you enjoyed it. They are going to work really hard every single week to bring you all their news and reviews. It's going to get better and better. They're doing a fantastic job. I did absolutely nothing. I just sat there and pressed record. They did everything. So if you see them in the corridor, give them a big well done and a big high five, because they deserve it. They did a tremendous job. So thank you, boys. Well done.